Chat. Welcome everyone to the Wake Up Call. I want to talk to you about some of the narratives out there regarding Donald Trump. The government, which obviously is the mainstream media, is gaslighting conservatives and quote-unquote conspiracy theorists, although the only real conspiracy theorists who are picking up on this story and running with it are those who are not very well-versed in what the government really does and how the government really operates, because the government is feeding into this notion that the shooter on the assassination or of the assassination attempt on Donald Trump didn't act alone. And this theory is out there because the media is allowing it to be out there. There's stories about how he fired 8 shots in under 6 seconds. And, of course, this whole notion of this kid being the shooter is obviously make-believe. I mean, everybody out there who believes that the narrative we're being fed isn't the real narrative is correct. Again, the mold of what these shooters look like, they always look the same, right? They look like they're all, well, the word starts with an R. And it's with a did. Every one of these shooters you can look at, you would say, how does that guy somehow sneak up on him and almost assassinate a president? Well, that's because it would never happen. And they mock us so much so that they put these people that you're not even allowed to call that word that I said out in the open as the ones who are responsible for these events. When it's, you know, anybody with eyes to see, ears to hear, and common sense would know that it's not possible for anybody to really outsmart the Secret Service. And remember, the notion that people have out there is that all the technology that the government has is just the same technology that we have, which couldn't be further from the truth. Nobody is getting anywhere near this area. Nobody who has a phone in their pocket is going to be anywhere near the Secret Service or the President of the United States without them knowing about it. We could never get near these people if we tried. They are fully protected, which is why they're going forward with all of these insane agendas that they have right now. So, I want to play for you some of the stuff and stick around for the whole video, because we need to talk about the predictive programming that's out there with the movie Shooter, because they're feeding into the conspiracy theorist narrative. Nobody's buying what they're selling, and they're almost gaslighting everybody out there into looking at this and saying, yeah, this doesn't seem right. This doesn't seem legitimate, the narrative they're giving us. And of course, that's not by design. That's not anybody out there uncovering and discovering this stuff. Just common logic would tell you that it's not possible for this to occur the way it is. Here's what nobody out there would tell you: that the entire thing was staged. That Donald Trump is worth more to the New World Order than potentially anybody on Earth right now. He is the most important person to go forward with the New World Order. Now, that blows the minds of conservatives because, again, they think that they've been going after Trump, these sham charade trials. They don't realize that all the things that they've done out in the open of Trump has been to get you to support him more, victimizing him, making him look like the government's really after them, so that you believe that, wow, he's really going to drain the swamp. He's really going to go after these people who are obviously bad people. They can't wrap their heads around him being one of them. And if they replace Donald Trump with anybody else, this whole divide and conquer, order out of chaos motto would not be able to work. He is that motto. Just think if you slipped anybody else into Trump's position, if you put any other political figure, people wouldn't care. People wouldn't care nowhere near this much. And the assassination attempt has obviously gotten him more support than we ever could have thought, imagined, which was done by design. If they wanted him dead, he would have been dead a long time ago. Okay, and I'll explain that to you and show you some of the technology they have. They don't even need to put a shooter out there to be able to assassinate somebody. But everybody, again, is getting gaslit by news stories like this that I'll play for you, where they're literally bringing out the Lee Harvey Oswald theory, which is comical. It's comical because everybody out there knows that the Lee Harvey Oswald theory is make-believe. Everybody. I mean, it doesn't matter if you're a Democrat or a Republican. It's a common sense thing now, right? Everybody knows that there's no magic bullet. There had to be more than one shooter. And, of course, everybody has their own theory about the CIA's involvement or if he was really shot in the first place. But we all know that the narrative that they gave us was nothing more than make-believe. It was, quote-unquote, he was a patsy. Just like they're making this guy Crooks out to be. They're literally using almost the same script. And they're gaslighting people out there with the these comparisons of how he was researching about how far away Lee Harvey Oswald was on the day of JFK's assassination. And of course, what the conservatives see when they hear this is it makes them say, wow, they're really trying to feed us this lone gunman theory, and they're not buying it, and they shouldn't be buying it. But what they should be saying is, was there even really an assassination attempt on Donald Trump, or is this all staged so that Donald Trump gets more and more support because he is the key piece in this divide and conquer, order out of chaos script that we are all living in? But here's the news, come take a look.
Stunning new details in the attempted assassination of former President Donald Trump. FBI Director Christopher Wray told lawmakers today that the gunman scoped out the Butler rally site with a drone on the day of the shooting. We're on the ground in Butler, Pennsylvania tonight. We want to start on Capitol Hill with Nicole Skangman. Nicole, what do we learn today?
Nora Ree's testimony revealed a number of facts about what this gunman did in the days leading up to the shooting. The FBI director said that Thomas Crooks visited the site of the rally a full week before the attempt on the former president's life. Tonight, we're learning the gunman who nearly assassinated former President Donald Trump entered a chilling Google search a week before the shooting.
On July 6th, he did a Google search for, quote, how far away was Oswald? Okay.
An FBI analysis of Crooks' laptop found he did the search on the same day he registered for Trump's rally. It references Lee Harvey Oswald, who assassinated President John F. Kennedy in 1963. Investigators are still looking into whether the gunman hid his firearm ahead of the rally.
The weapon had a collapsible stock, which could explain why it might have been less easy for people to observe.
A CBS News analysis found Crooks fired 8 bullets in less than 6 seconds before being shot and killed by a Secret Service sniper.
Why was Crooks allowed to get off 8 shots?
Well, that, I think, is something we're still digging into.
In his testimony today, Ray also detailed what Crooks did to prepare ahead of this assassination attempt. Jen Barrasso with our CBS station in Pittsburgh has more from Butler, Pennsylvania.
Hours before shots rang out, 20-year-old Crooks flew a drone roughly 200 yards from where we're standing right now and from where President Trump was standing on July 13th.
Investigators recovered the drone and at least 2 crude explosives in Crooks' vehicle, as well as another explosive in his Bethel Park, Pennsylvania home.
This is him.
New body cam video shows law enforcement confirming the 20-year-old shooter had been identified as a suspicious person before opening fire.
It is, quite frankly, a dangerous time to be a prominent public official.
CBS News has learned there have been talks between the Trump campaign and U.S. Secret Service about indoor venues versus outdoor venues for future rallies because of ongoing security concerns. Nora?
CBS's Jen Barrasso with that new reporting. And Nicole Skanga, thank you so much.
Okay, so everybody out there with common sense can see that news clip. You can see how they're trying so hard, but they're not, to explain to people how Crooks was able to do this, even though the notion of firing 8 shots in under 6 seconds and how he wasn't shot first, they can't give you an explanation for it, right? And this is getting people really angry because they're going, the narrative they're giving us isn't real. Now they're comparing it to Lee Harvey Oswald. Anyone with common sense knows that Lee Harvey Oswald was not. There was no lone gunman. That whole theory has been disproved. It's laughable that if there's anyone out there that even believes it, I don't think there are, right? So people are suspicious because what they're giving is obviously not truth, but they're not suspicious for the right reasons. They can't wrap their heads around psychological operations and how they work, how there wasn't really an attempt on his life. Now, what you're seeing is this new movement of conspiracy theorists. There are a lot of people who are jumping into all of this stuff, trying to case crack, solve this stuff. And just like the Epstein list, these are things that the government is feeding to these people to try to solve, but they don't realize that they're in the PSYOP itself, right? And the notion is this film Shooter, starring Mark Wahlberg. They're trying to make this into predictive programming, where Mark Wahlberg went to this, there was going to be an assassination on a president. Mark Wahlberg's character goes to try to stop the assassination attempt. They go through with it, and they try to frame Mark Wahlberg. This film right here This narrative in this movie is what conservatives are running with and also calling it predictive programming, which we're seeing them bait people into all these things now, thinking that they're waking up, they're showing predictive programming, but this is not predictive programming from the standpoint of them setting up this crooks guy. This crooks guy, for all we know, he could have been dead before he was on the roof. It's obviously, you know, there's the theories of, is it even the same guy? They don't look alike. I've seen all the stuff that's circulating. You can make your own decision on that, but one thing is clear, that this guy, this kid, didn't get 8 shots fired off in 6 seconds without the government knowing about it. Patsies are real. Manchurian candidates are real. They place these people in these positions, and this movie has a similar theme. So everybody out there thinks that they put that kid there to frame him for the assassination attempt on Donald Trump, but it's not true. Look at this predictive program that a lot of conservatives are running with.
It's going to be the attempt on the life of the president. You've been taken from the other mile.
5 or 6 men in a row, and you're shot like that.
We need you to stop it. Out of all the men alive on the planet, you're one of the few people who knows what to look for.
This guy knows what he's doing. You gotta take him.
It's inside. Take him now.
So that's the movie trailer for Shooter. And again, you can see the similarities. You can see why people are looking at that and saying it's predictive programming, because they're not believing the narrative that this kid was the one who attempted to take Donald Trump's life. And the media and the government want you to believe it. They want you to think it's a conspiracy to assassinate and eliminate Trump. What they don't want you to do is wake up to the left and right and the sham that it is and realize it's all political theater. Because if you wake up to that and you realize that you're being played, then they lose their stranglehold over you. They lose their power over you. They need you invested in this. And like I said earlier in the video, Donald Trump is the most important piece in all of this stuff going forward. Most conservatives think that's the craziest thing they've ever heard. How could that possibly be? Because they don't understand psychological operations, right? You're emotionally invested in this guy. All they've done over the last 4 to 8 years is victimize him. They've made him out in the open, sham trials. They go after him. The media slanders him. And what that does without you realizing it is it makes you love him more. The media knows this. That's why they do this. Don't you think they would have stopped portraying him this way if they realized it was having an adverse effect on people and they were becoming obsessed with him and going to his rallies and he was more supported than ever? The notion of the rigged election, all that did was build him up more. 4 years of utter hell, right, with Joe Biden as president, right? Everybody felt the stuff going on with him as president as far as how expensive things were getting, the ridiculous stuff they were gaslighting us with at the White House with the transgender on Easter. All these things have been done deliberately because that's how the government works psychologically. They don't expect you to ever think about how they can mold and manipulate your mind. They want you to think that you're making all these decisions freely. But they're feeding you a lot of these conspiracies. As long as you believe there was an attempted assassination on Trump, that's the point. Because if you believe that this stuff is actually real and not a simulation, then you're easier to mold and manipulate. And everybody who's stuck in this MAGA situation doesn't realize that they're victims of a psychological operation. They get very offended. They get very hurt. You've all seen and dealt with that now. So the other thing I want to point out is the technology that they have, how advanced it is, right? If they wanted Donald Trump dead, he would have been dead a long time ago. If they wanted Donald Trump out of this race, they wouldn't have given him such a spotlight on TV. They wouldn't talk about him every day, right? The best way to erase somebody is to just never mention their name again. And what have we seen even while Biden was president? They were giving us updates daily on what Donald Trump was doing and where he was going. And the whole 4 years was about documents and Trump's, you know, Mar-a-Lago. All these things were keeping him in your mind, right? Deliberately, because that's where the script was heading, to where we are now. But for those of you that don't know, for anybody out there that's like, okay, I don't believe this guy, and I think the government was really trying to kill him. Are you aware that DARPA has smart bullets? Are you aware of the fact that they don't even need, it doesn't matter who is up there, that they have this type of technology, which is dated technology? Because remember, all the technology they tell us that they have
They're 50 years minimum ahead with the type of tech that they have. And we know with the directed energy weapons and all the other stuff we've seen behind over the last couple of years, just how insane the technology is, but it's even more insane than you can imagine. So DARPA has openly admitted them about, you know, talked about and shown the smart bullets that they have. Smart bullets, you wouldn't be able to get away from a smart bullet. If they wanted Trump dead, they would just do this to him. They would have offed him a long time ago. They could have offed him the next day after the fake assassination attempt. How people don't think that's possible is beyond me, right? He's out in the open, he goes here, he goes and plays golf. You don't think that they could take him out whenever they want to? Of course they can. Now, why did they do it the way that they did it? They did it that way because they wanted you to see it, the entire thing unfold. If they tried to take him out on a golf course, they wouldn't be able to stage this production. They wouldn't be able to have the cameras and the photograph of Trump yelling, fight, fight, fight. They wouldn't be able to show you the magic bullet whizzing by his head, which is Photoshop. All these things are to get you invested in the PSYOP. But let me just show you this couple of DARPA's smart bullet, because again, you might be under the impression that there was real bullets. You might think that he smacked a ketchup packet on his ear, did a little WWF acting, or bladed his ear with a razor. Whatever you possibly think, just understand that smart bullets exist. And the government wouldn't hire and frame some kid that looks like he couldn't even walk down the street without falling over to be the patsy in this situation. If the government wanted him gone, they could use this type of technology any day of the week at any time they want to take him out.
It's nothing new that the U.S. military has smart bombs, bombs that are self-guided to hit targets with super accuracy. Now, the Pentagon's research agency, DARPA, is creating smart bullets. The project is codenamed EXACTO, Extreme Accuracy Task Ordnance. If successful, EXACTO would be the first ever small caliber bullet that could steer itself. This DARPA EXACTO video shows the path of an experimental smart bullet which was intentionally shot off target. Watch it do something ordinary bullets simply cannot do. While it slices through the air at hundreds of miles per hour, it changes course and turns toward its target. The bullets could help American snipers overcome challenging weather conditions, like high winds. So here's how they work. The tips of each bullet include optical sensors. These sensors send signals to tiny fins on the bullets, which adjust the path toward the target. These bullets are still in development, so it might be a while before we see them in action. Project EXACTO's goal of creating a better bullet is ultimately aimed at saving more American lives on the battlefields of the future.
So the smart bullet is something that's 10, 20 years old at this point. The government can take out anyone they want at any time. So if you actually think it was a failed assassination attempt, and you don't realize how they're baiting you, especially as a Christian, into thinking that it was divine intervention. I showed in that video clip, very early on after the assassination, the repetition, right? Repetition is the key to mind control. What was the media? What was everyone out there saying? The same talking points.
The devil came to Pennsylvania holding a rifle, but an American lion got back up on his feet and
it's like raises to the ear. I mean, that is divine intervention, that he was not, you know, mortally wounded.
They stepped in, God, the hand of God, call it whatever you like.
Evil came for the man we admire and love. I thank God that his hand was on President Trump.
The fact that this is about milliseconds and millimeters that changes this from being an attempt and an assassination should really talk about the divine intervention that has occurred here.
Trump is truly blessed. And a God being able to evade being assassinated.
And we thank him for protecting our next president, Donald J. Trump.
It was a clear assassination attempt. I think there was maybe some divine intervention.
If you didn't believe in miracles before Saturday, you better be believing right now.
It was God alone who prevented the unthinkable from happening.
So that was truly divine intervention as far as I'm concerned.
It's having everybody on the internet saying this is divine intervention. Every frame of the attempted assassination is nothing short of proof that it was divine intervention.
We, Mr. Cale,
on President Trump. God must have been watching down on the president.
I personally believe that God intervened today, not just on behalf of President Trump, but on behalf of our country.
I'll say that, in my opinion, probably the most famous NFL catch in history is called the Immaculate Reception. I call this the Immaculate Protection. I believe that there was divine intervention to make sure nothing happened to this man. It's extraordinary.
Which, let's just be real. Donald Trump is anointed by God. Whether you believe in God or not, he had a divine intervention that saved his life. And you can call me crazy, but I think that's the only thing that truly saved Donald Trump. And now he's going to have more support than he's ever had.
Willie, you're right. He's been posting on his Truth Social account. Here's his latest post. It came in just moments ago. Thank you to everyone for your thoughts and prayers yesterday. It was God alone, he said, who prevented the unthinkable from happening. We will fear not, but instead remain resilient in our faith and defiant in the face of wickedness.
When God shows up, then clearly it's hard for even the biggest detractors to deny it. They go, what did I just watch? You just watched God turn Donald Trump's head, literally. We all just watched it. I mean, think about God making his presence known. I mean, on the biggest possible story you ever could. Now you've got people going, okay, I believe it. I believe it.
They were feeding you divine intervention by design to manipulate you, to make you think that God intervened with an attempted assassination on Donald Trump because he's a prophet. He's going to save America. Right? A lot of these people have such a warped perspective. In America specifically, they think the world revolves around America, that everything in the Bible is about American prophecy. They don't realize that the government is using the Bible, in a sense, to manipulate them. They're trying to bait Christians into deception. And the Bible talks about great deceptions, right? But they look at America as if, like, America is this great big thing and everything has to run through America and God's country is America. This is part of the problem that we're seeing with Christians falling into very easy deceptions, right? They're getting their ears tickled, as the Bible says. They're listening to these things, thinking the prophecies being fulfilled in the sense of a guy who is literally one of them, and they don't want to hear it. They don't want to hear him. The Bible talks about being deceived, even the elect shall be received. There's so many scriptures that are about deception. So what do these people think the deception actually is? You know, they just don't want to ever think that they're getting duped, of course, and they don't realize that all the years of all the persecution in the public of Donald Trump is part of the design. That it is part of, you wouldn't support him or care this much if the media wasn't gaslighting you for 8 years with Donald Trump being under attack. You also feel like you're under attack as a Christian because of what? The free speech suppression, the other things that we see going on, the Sodom and Gomorrah that we're living in, that they're gaslighting all of us with every single day. You have to be smart enough to understand that these people are smarter than we are because we're in their game. They're the ones who are manipulating our reality, our perspective on reality. They understand how the human mind works. But if you have a society of narcissists and people out there think that they know better, the government's not smarter than they are, they have no idea about things like Operation Paperclip and just how long the government has been experimenting on the human brain, okay? They know how to get you to do this, how to get you to do that, how to get you to think this, and how to get you to think that, beyond our comprehension. So everything that goes on in the news is out there to manipulate you. It's not out there to inform you. It's out there to control you, especially the stuff with Donald Trump. What better way would you ever get somebody to get this kind of support? Ever. If anybody else was in the position of Trump running for president, nobody would care. They wouldn't give a crap. And the fact that it's been 8 years of conditioning, and then right now they pull this fake assassination attempt, it's designed so you are so deceived and so blinded that you're going to do whatever they tell you to do. And that's what's going to come out of this fake election. Again, not a rigged election, a fake election. This is nothing more than a psychological operation. So people out there, they're obviously gaslighting you. Because anybody who believes the actual narrative just doesn't even think clearly, right? The narrative that this kid went up there and outsmarted the Secret Service, you don't even need to even debate anybody on that notion that it wasn't just some lone gunman. He wasn't Googling Lee Harvey Oswald that morning and then flying a drone. You wouldn't be able to get a drone up over the area. Are you joking me? You know how long when they do these rallies, this stuff is staged out, and there's already, you know, government officials there for days before. So if they saw a drone over this guy, not only would it have been shot out, they would have tracked it back to him, and he would have been arrested on the spot. So the notion that most of these conservatives have is that he was working with the government. He was not a lone gunman, and there was more gunmen. And he's the fall guy for the government. So nobody's believing this narrative. They don't want you to believe it. They're making it overly obvious that this kid couldn't have done this by himself, right? So then they want you to think kind of like that plot of that new movie coming out, right? Captain America, that somebody on the inside with Trump obviously is compromised. And I mean, all the predictive programming is out there. So when you're getting baited into this stuff and you're seeing all the stuff that they want you to see about the shooter, realize that they want you to see this. They're telling you this stuff to get you more angry, to think that there's a conspiracy that you can go and solve. But the conspiracy itself is that the news is fake and that they script these things out. And why is it so hard for people to believe that? I mean, are these the same people who watch reality TV and think that that is real? That that's what Kim Kardashian is doing every day? Here's a newsflash. If the Kardashians, keeping up with the Kardashians was real, and we were really following Kim around all day, and the cameras were showing us her real life, well, we would see a lot of ritual sacrifice, okay? It's scripted television. Reality TV is just as scripted as fictional TV, and the news is just as scripted as any fictional TV or movie out there, if not more. That's what most of these people can't wrap their heads around, that they can script these events out, that they can put actors in place. And some of these events, are there real civilians there? Yes, there are real civilians there. I guarantee you the majority of people at this rally were agents. The majority. Not just 20 people, not just 100 people, the majority of them. And by telling us that there's a lone shooter, and how did he do this, and that he's Googling Lee Harvey Oswald that night, he's flying drones, they know that the majority of people are going to go, okay, that can't be real. It just can't be. It's too suspicious. Yeah, exactly. They're telling you that it can't be real. The problem is that the more you try to solve this case, the better it is for the government, because they want you to think you're solving a case and continue going down the rabbit hole, instead of coming to the realization that they script the news to manipulate your perception of reality. And then they get you to invest emotionally in a man that you've never met, that you know nothing about. What do you know about him? All you know is what the television has told you about him, that the government keeps going after him, and he's a man of God, supposedly. But you don't really know him. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is hypnotism, hypnosis, and that's what they're creating. I thank everybody for being here. I hope you're all doing well. Share this video with people out there. Try to wake them up to this stuff. I know how frustrated most of you are with this because of the way people are responding to it, because people refuse to believe. You know, they believe. And that's one of the reasons they created fake news. The notion of fake news that Trump created was to make you look at the news, like the perception of the newscasters is the fake news. So when they're talking about Mar-a-Lago and the documents, right, and the news is just saying Trump should go to jail for a long period of time, everyone goes, that's fake news. They're just, you know, they're framing them, it's fake news. They don't look at it and go, wait, fake news? You mean that the news itself is scripted and fake to warp your perception of reality and then to manipulate you into wanting this or wanting that, wanting these laws changed and passed, hating your fellow neighbor because of their political ideologies? Exactly. That's what it's there for. It's nothing more than a mind control tool. I thank everybody for being here. Hope you're all well. God bless you and your families, as always.